I welcome all of you to this live session. So we have planned this live session in three slots today. So initially, we will take the questions on LaTeX, and then we will have questions on soft skill and workplace communication, and then English for oral and written communication. So I think many of you are new to MOOCs. So if I suggest that if you are totally new to MOOCs, so I suggest that you join the demo course where you will get an idea like how to navigate the course, and then it'll be easier for you to manage your course well. And many people have asked whether when they will get the certificate. So the answer is, you will get the certificate after the course ends. So I think we have made all these courses as a self-paced course. That means you can join anytime within this period of July 15 to July November 15th. Is the last date, and you can register up to October 16th. And within these 4 months, you can take the course as you wish in your own pace. And after you finish the course, you'll immediately after the course ends, you will get the certificate. So it will be around November middle or end. For English course, it will be end of November because there is also some manual grading required. So that is a common question which a lot of people want to know. So, but only thing is, you have to clear the course. So unless you clear the course with the passing grade, you will not get the certificate. So once you clear the, so you can always see your progress in the progress bar. And if you have any questions regarding any of the administrative problems, you can always email to coursesupport@cse.iitb.ac.in. So that is what I want to tell. And regarding any subject related questions, you have to always post on the discussion forum, because discussion forum is the place where you should ask any subject related questions. And if you have any administrative related questions like your login problem, password problem, or certificate issues, all those questions you can always send an email. And if it is a problem, then we will sort it out. So please feel free to post your questions either on discussion forum or send it to us through email. So without much ado, now I invite Firoza to answer LaTeX related questions. So thank you all, and I wish you good luck, and I hope you'll do well in all the courses in which you have joined. Thank you.
Thank you, madam. So yes, welcome everybody to this interactive live session. So as Kalpana ma'am said, we will be starting with the LaTeX course, and I'm Firuza. I'll be handling all your queries. So let's get started with, sorry.
Firuza, sorry to interrupt you. Can you, so the one more thing I just want to add, like whoever is asking questions, they should switch on their audio as well as their video, because we are recording this session. So Firoza, if you're, it will be nice if you can come on the camera. Thank you.
Yes, ma'am. So welcome everybody. So let's get started with the questions that you have asked using the Google form, which was circulated. So the first one is, what is the use of LipSim? LipSim is nothing but, lorem ipsum. So some dummy text that does not make sense, which is actually used by designers and typesetting industry to fill in the gaps in a document. Or say if you're designing a website and you want to show how the content will appear, say you have your header, which is big, then you have some content on the left, you have some content in the center, maybe some content in the footer, you know, all these things. But you have to fill it up. Otherwise, how will people understand how your website is looking or how your document is looking? Well, so that is what actually LipSim is. So LipSim over here is a package which is actually using the Lorem Ipsum website for generating random text. So in day-to-day life, you will not need it, except like you are showing a demo or something like that, which I have already specified. So like in the course, like we are displaying multiple paragraphs. Why? So that we don't have to scroll up and down, and I don't want to bother by writing hello, how are you, or some random text manually. So Ipsum is nothing but dummy text. Is LaTeX still relevant today with Word being widely used? Well, a very big yes. LaTeX is definitely being used, and as time is passing by, many more people are using it. Well, in fact, now journals and conferences, many of them, not all though, but they are now making it mandatory to use. So, well, LaTeX is becoming popular day by day. It started almost 35 years back, and professionals, academicians, scientists, all of them use it, irrespective of the field. So like if you are even in it's not that just CS people use it or just programming people use it. Well, it's a wrong conception. People in humanities, people in biology, people in civil, mechanical, all of them use it. Yeah. Okay. So the other question is how to start a paragraph from the next page instead of the same page. Well, say suppose you're writing a document and you want to have a paragraph on the next page. So what you would do before you start the paragraph, you'd write a command called slash page break, which we have also seen in our sessions, I guess, in topic 3. So, well, after whatever you write after slash page break, naturally the contents or the paragraph will appear on the next page. Sure. The other one is, will LaTeX be taught using Windows platform or Linux? Well, to answer this, LaTeX can be used on any operating system. So the what code that you write in your .tech file. And then when you build and run it, you get a PDF file. So LaTeX generates a PDF file, which it will be the same irrespective of your operating system. So here we use Ubuntu, but while recording the lectures, we used Windows operating system. So to answer your question, well, it doesn't matter whether the course is using Windows or Linux or Mac. It is just that you install LaTeX and you get started with it. In Beamer, next question. In Beamer, you taught two transition styles, slash pause and slash on slide. Are these the only transition styles in LaTeX, or there are some other two? Well, to answer your question, these are nothing but overlays. So yes, there are other styles. There is another one called slash only command, with which you can have text only on that particular slide of the document. So let me just present my screen. Yes, can everybody see my screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, please. Thank you. So I'll just change the document class as Beamer, and instead of this hello everyone, we'll say begin a frame slash begin frame, wherein we'll say that let's have some random text first line, then we'll put slash slash, we'll say second line, and with a new line another one called third line. Right, let's build and run this. So I pressed F5. So as you can see, we have these three lines on the same presentation slide. Well, if you want that first slide should appear only on one slide, second should appear on the second one, third should appear on the third one, well, there's another command called slash only, and then in the angular brackets you would write one. Similarly, you can write two here, and third, you'll write three. And let's build and run this. Sorry, just 1 second. Yeah, you have to put it in curly braces. So first line, then comes your second line, yeah, and then the third line. Let's build and run this now. There's no frame to end here. Okay, but let's see. Slash only. One, two, and three. Seems okay. Let's build and run again. No, why does it say that end frame is not required? It has actually generated, but I'm not sure why the error message is. Let's see, I'll put it up on the discussion forum after editing it. Let's see, it should work. Document class Vima, yeah. Things are looking fine, but let's see, I'll resolve the error. I just don't want to waste time of everybody. So there would be other ways as well. I mean, many other packages are also there. If you want, you can actually Google CTAN. So it's a comprehensive tech network, which actually has multiple packages. So if you go there, you will find the packages for your own discipline as well. Okay. The next command is, the next question is, how to write subscript and superscript shapes like arrow, circle, etc. So superscript and subscript we have covered in mathematics section. So let me write a document class article, and let me just comment this out. We can document and document. So say you want to write 2 raised to 2. So in dollars, you would write 2. Then this operator, which is on the keypad, keyboard number 6. So 2 raised to 2. And let's build and run this. So as you can see, the number 2 is in superscript. And similarly, say you want, let's make a 3. Say another one, you want 2 and subscript 3. So you would write underscore and 3. And let's build and run that. So now you have 2 raised to 3 and 2 subscript of 3. So this is how you add superscript and subscript. The next question was, how do we add shapes like arrows and circle? So let me go to the website. So if you see, I have opened up a PDF. You can Google comprehensive LaTeX symbols, and the very first link would be this PDF file. Just open it. It's a very large document of 348 pages. And let's say you want arrows. So let's go search over here, arrows. So it's on table number 139. Let's click on it. So well, you get all these kind of arrows. Say you want an arrow on top of a particular letter or a word. So that would be vec. Let's Google slash, let's search slash vec. So well, let's search more. Yeah, so say if you write slash vec and in curly braces you write A, it will appear something like this. So well, if you just copy paste this, it would appear. All right, let's go to the next question. In the topic on use of reference link URLs in article, I constantly get a message while running the code, require package ref count. Well, the reason is that not the entire LaTeX is installed. So when you installed either using Miktex or TechLive, not entire LaTeX has got installed. Some packages have got missed out. Well, there are ways to do that. So you open Miktex console, then click updates and check for updates. If there are any updates, update it, click update now. Then go to the packages. So in the left pane, there will be something called as packages. Click on packages, and then in the text box, you write ref count package, and then click on the plus sign. That means you are installing the package. So this way, I guess you will be able to resolve this error. Next question. I'll share the PDF link. Not this one. Yeah. Just a second. I'll share it in a while. Say in the topic on making presentation using Beamer, I get install package Beamer base 2 screen.sty not found. So like what I suggested in the previous question is you open Miktex and maybe you can search this particular file in MicTech and install it. You should be able to resolve this error. If not, please feel free to get back on the discussion forum. Another is, I'm using MacBook Pro running on Mac OS Catalina. The application downloaded for using LaTeX is TechShop. I would like to know whether all the features that is being shown in Tech Studio can be used in TechShop. Well, to answer this question, I have opened up a wiki article which says comparison of text editors. Well, so these are the various text editors and these are the parameters here. So, well, it says editing style, operating system, stable, release version, cost, license, you know, all those things. So, well, if you go down, there is something called as Tech Shop. What you can do is you can compare. So, well, if you go to see, Tech Studio is supported on Linux, Windows, and Mac OS, whereas Tech Shop is only on Mac OS. It is free. Both are GPL versions, but one is, I guess, version number 2. Here, version number is not listed. And what is this particular column saying? Integrated viewer. Integrated viewer is what we see on the right. So, well, yes, it says that there is an integrated viewer. So, if you go to see, basic things are definitely matching with Tech Studio. Coming to the properties of an editor, so which is inverse search, BD support, organizes project, menu for inserting symbols, document comparison, spell check, multiple undo and redo. So, well, that would also be, that is also very similar, except that here there are two no's, which is organizing of project and BDs. In fact, even this one, so you cannot have comparisons here, but other features are definitely supported. Over here, like, you have collapsible sections, find and replace using regular expressions, so parenthesis matching. So, well, if you see, only the very first column saying collapsible section is not supported in Tech Shop, but in Tech Studio it is supported. Other things are like quite a yes. So, if you compare, more or less, you will be able to use all the features of Tech Studio in Tech Shop. But of course, each editor has its own advantages and disadvantages. Well, but actually, it doesn't matter. So, you can use Tech Shop if you like. So, then I'm unable to compile the file using Tech Studio more than 2 pages. It was showing errors. I could not comprehend the question. So can you please write in the chat or on the discussion forum exactly what were the errors you were facing? Second question which you have posted is, using article class, the table of contents gives me 0.1, 0.2. Well, it means that your document does not have a section, but it has a subsection. So let's see, what does that mean? Okay, let me just comment this out. And let's say I'm adding some content here. And instead of a section, I'm writing subsection. All right, let's say title, and let's generate the table of contents using the table of contents command. Let's build and run it 2 times. 2 times, why? Because table of contents gets generated only when you build and run your document 2 times. So as you can see here, 0.1, which is the actual subsection, and the title has 0.1 because there is no section. Which section does it correspond to? Like, it doesn't have a parent. Similarly, table of contents also has something similar. So let's add another subsection here, / subsection. Let's say another one. Let's build and run this 2 times. So you see another 0.2 has appeared. Now let's add a section here. Section called hello. So now this is 1 and this is 1.1. But since this doesn't have a section, this is still 0.1. Similarly, the table of contents is also updated. So now if you add a section just above that, your problem would be solved. I hope I have answered this too. And okay, somebody has asked, how do you write a document in LaTeX? Well, I request you to please refer the lecture materials, video, slides, code, enhanced article. Well, the actual course is about writing document in LaTeX. If you have a specific query, I'll be happy to answer. So I'm done with the questions which are posted on the Google form. Well, let's see the questions which are asked here. Ma'am, I'm new to this course. I am using TechWorks, but after run, it doesn't show the PDF file. It says there's a problem with some missing files. What missing files exactly? The question is by Preetpal Singh. Also, maybe can you also check whether the tech file, the PDF file appears in the folder where you have saved it? So like, for example, over here, test.tech, it is saved in Firuza desktop latex test.tech. So if this doesn't appear due to some reason, let's go to the desktop latex. Yeah, so you see there are many other files which have got generated along with the PDF file. Can you please check whether this these files are... So if you want, you can please speak. You can unmute and speak. Preetpal Singh.
Ma'am, can I ask a question?
Sorry?
I have a question about horizontal and vertical spacing and first line indents and all that.
Sure, we'll come to it. But since like I have already opened up this question, Preetpal Singh, could you please unmute yourself and...
Okay, I'll wait till later. Thank you.
Yes, please. Thank you so much.
Ma'am, I'll again make the program and send to the screen share live.
No, what is the problem? What exactly
he
is the problem?
He is not able to see the PDF on the right.
PDF on the right. So probably it is not installed. I mean, the viewer is not there integrated. So is he using TechStudio?
Are you using TechStudio? Which LaTeX editor are you using? Okay, Preetpal, we'll come back to you. How do you use different font styles like Arial Black font in TechStudio? So LaTeX, the current one, what the font that is there, which is computer modern font of text. So if you want to use particular font styles, I have covered it in topic 3, but let me show you here. LaTeX font styles. Just a second. Let me start the course. Let me show you from the course itself. Yeah, so if you refer to this LaTeX font catalog, it gives you different styles that you would need. So serif fonts which are similar to Times New Roman are put up here. So you can refer to any particular one. Say you want, say this particular one. So if you click here, it will show you how you can use it. So you have to use a package. And then you say use package Allegria, and then using this command, and then the normal font will give you this. IT shape will give you this style, italic, BF series will give you this style. So this is another one. Let's go, these are the serif fonts. Sans serif fonts, which are similar to Arial, will give you these type of fonts. So you can choose any one of them and you can actually go ahead with it. Similarly, like if you click a particular one, and you would see it would get generated in this way, and these are the commands that you need to insert. Yeah, so what I'll do is I'll just put these links on the chat. So it's LaTeX font catalog. And let me put the symbols also on the chat. And comparison of LaTeX editors as well. All right. Ma'am, can you send this PDF link for reference, okay? Amani is writing, we have literature background, but we are getting scientific method questions in grades. Can you suggest a simple way to overcome this problem? Scientific method questions as in, you mean in the graded quizzes? Well, I don't think there is any scientific question in graded quizzes or graded assignments. Could you speak, Amani?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, please.
Ma'am, well, we are doing that questions in grade, ma'am. Somehow we are getting some questions like in scientific method related to technology or technical related engineering courses.
Which particular one? Because I do not recall.
Patent rights, ma'am. Related to patent rights. Patent rights.
Patent rights. Yeah. I'm sorry, which course? Are you talking of LaTeX course?
No, ma'am. Soft skills only.
Okay. Sorry. So, I'm currently addressing the LaTeX course.
Okay.
So, you can ask this question. Somebody would definitely answer this. My session is still for another 10-15 minutes. After that, you can definitely ask this question.
Sure, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you. Anju is asking, while preparing project reports, every time it becomes a problem to align the images in the right place. But every time the position keeps changing and we are unable to make it at the proper place. What can be done in this regard? So images are usually trial and error ones. So LaTeX actually positions it where it feels it is best for the reader to actually refer to images. So if you want the images to appear exactly in the same way, well, it would depend on how much content also you have written in the document along with the images. So a better way would be to add a box bracket here. So when you write /begin figure, and then you have your include graphics package and all other commands, you can write a position which is H. In case it still doesn't work out, what you can do is you can make it capital H and include a package called float /use package float. So, well, that would place the figure exactly where you have positioned it. So you could try this out. How to include EPS files in LaTeX? The very way, the same way as you would include a .jpg or a .png file, just write an extension .eps and it will work. Preetpal, yes, PDF LaTeX did not succeed. MidTech compiler driver did not succeed. Okay. What it seems is that MidTech itself is not installed properly. Could you do me a favor if you could just uninstall MidTech and install it once again? And when you're installing MidTech, in case it gives you a basic version or full version, choose the full version so that you get all the packages.
Okay, ma'am, when I was downloading this as a link given by you in the first part of the lecture.
Right.
There was only one option for this, it automatically starts downloaded.
Yes, after downloading, when you are installing in case it gives you. So I'm over here on MidTech page, and let me click the downloads button, and say if I'm on Windows, so usually I would get this particular link. In case
yes, ma'am.
You are having different editions, maybe you could, I guess not this one, so I don't think you should go in for this one. So you could go in for this, and after that, you could, while installing, if it asks you to go for basic version or advanced, you can go in for a full LaTeX version. What it seems is that MikTeX itself is not installed here. This is what I can gather from this, because it says MikTeX compile driver did not succeed.
So, okay.
Yeah. So you can try it out and you can get back on the discussion forum. Sometime back, somebody had asked about horizontal and vertical spacing. Could you please come up?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, please. Hi.
I want to control space between paragraphs. I want to remove first line indent, etc. I couldn't find any commands so far in the four lessons that I've taken. So I would do backslash par and backslash h space. But there must be a way to change the settings altogether, right? So that I have control over space between paras and first line indent.
Yes, sir. You would do that using, you would define the new command. Can I get back to you on this, on the discussion forum?
I'll write to you on the discussion forum.
Yes, please. I will get back to you by end of the day.
Okay. Thank you.
Yes, thank you. Yes, please. Anybody else would like to speak up? Yes, please go ahead. You can unmute yourself or you can write on the chat. For me, Beamer is not working at all. Other programs are working fine, running successfully. What error do you get when you run Beamer? You can, in fact, if you want, I can stop presenting and you can share the screen as well. So, Nilesri, if you would like, you can share your screen.
Yes, madam.
Yes, please. Yeah, Nilesri, are you sharing your screen?
Madam, I'm just opening the app first to open the program. Should I do that or should I share the screen of what error I'm getting? Snapshot I'll share?
Yeah, you can share the screen because I don't think you can share the snapshot on Google Meet over here.
Okay, fine, sir.
Yeah, sure, Prithpal, we can go ahead. Let us finish with Nilesri.
Just a second, ma'am. I'm just sure I'll share.
Yes.
Ma'am, you are able to see?
Yes, please.
Ma'am, if I take a Beamer, now this example I am opening, this is Beamer example. Actually, all other programs I was able to successfully get all documents. Only the Beamer thing, any type of Beamer program I try to open, it is not showing. Say, for example, ma'am, are you able to see the program?
Yes.
Okay, fine. I have done the run program. So, ma'am, this package installation problem is coming again and again.
Yes. So, somebody else also raised this question. So, what did you click? So, when it says, you can just click install.
Ma'am, I did install also. Now, when I do install here, it says, okay, fine. It comes a pop-up like my text package manager. Do you want to allow this program for an unknown publisher to make changes to your device? I say yes. And then later on, I get like this process started. And then later on, it does not run. Finally, it gives me this error. See, madam. Beamer base 2 screens dot sty not found.
Can you do me a favor? Can you open Miktex?
Miktex.
Yes, please. Yeah, this one. Say run as administrator. So when it opens up, you can close it and say, or you can say switch to Miktex administrator mode. Everybody, please see this because many people usually face this problem. What happened?
Ma'am, it comes as a Miktex console window.
Somebody started sharing the screen. Sorry, actually I'm not able to see. Shinde Vikas, can you stop presenting because Nilashree is presenting her screen. And I'm unable to see right now. Where is...
Should I, ma'am, should I also stop sharing for a while?
No, you do not stop sharing. Yeah, okay. Did you click run as administrator?
Yes, madam. I clicked run as administrator.
Now, on the left hand side, there is something called as updates in the left pane.
Yes updates is there.
Click check for updates.
Check for updates. Okay, I clicked checking for updates. It's checking now.
Yes, please.
Okay, a list came out. Yeah.
Right. You can click update now. And try it out again. In case that doesn't work, then on the left, after this happens, I guess this will take a while.
Yeah.
If you see installing Babel, there would be many more. And I guess your Beamer packages will also get installed using this command. If it doesn't happen, then on the left hand side, just below the updates, there is something called as packages. You click there. Right now, I don't think it will be active. I guess once everything gets installed, you can click packages and then write the package, the .sty, you know what, Beamer 2, whatever it was, you write over there and click the plus icon. That would install that package and I guess you should be able to run Beamer.
Okay. Because madam, other things are perfectly fine, no? So only this, I was having some issues. Simple program also on Beamer was not working there. That's why.
Yes.
Okay, yeah, ma'am. So should I get back to you later on discussion forum if at all I am able to successfully do it?
Yes, please, definitely.
Okay, because update is in progress. It is 89% right now.
Right.
Okay, done. It says it's almost done.
Yeah.
Okay,
open the Just
a second.
So should I stop sharing here?
Okay, you can stop sharing. In case it, in case my session is still on, and then if you try it out, let me know whether it has worked.
Yes, definitely, ma'am. Madam, one more thing. Now, update is in progress is coming, so it will take time, right? Because packages ka button is not getting
It's
not clickable right
things,
now.
Right. All these things should get active again, like how it was some time back. So
okay.
After, I think this message should change to something else, like
okay,
update done or something of that sort.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, fine, ma'am. I'll stop sharing then. Yeah.
Yes, yes. Thank you.
Thank you, madam.
Thank you. Yes, Preetpal, you can share your screen. Yes, specified installation directory is not empty. Did you uninstall Miktex? That is because Miktex is already installed and it is trying to install in the same directory.
No, ma'am, I once uninstalled it from control panel from my computer.
Okay, just click on this OK button.
Okay.
Yeah, if you see, there is something called as you would need to go here, or you can you can go to this path, user ECS app data local programs and Miktex.
Yes,
go
ma'am.
To that path on your computer using the file browser and delete
okay.
whatever is there in that
inside
Miktex. Or you can delete the Miktex folder also. Programs, I guess. User, ECS, app data, local and programs.
Okay, ma'am, I'm deleting it. Please wait.
Yes, please. Have you shared the screen? Because I can see only the Miktex installer screen.
Okay, ma'am, I'm sharing the full screen.
Yes, yes.
Ma'am, is it visible?
Yes, please. Yeah, it was user ECS app data. Is app data.
Okay. Users ECS app data. App data is not here. What's the problem?
So go to the search and type there percentage app data percentage.
What is percentage here?
Percentage but symbol.
What is yeah? But what does percentage do here?
So directly go to the app data. Go to the run start run.
So somebody has Mehul Wala has posted on the chat in Windows. Press the window button and R, and then type percent app data.
Miktex. Okay.
Click on the start from where you start the programs.
Yes, sir.
Get the run.
Hello.
Yeah, click on the run.
Yes, sir.
Type percentage symbol, then app data, a capital.
Yes, sir.
D capital data.
Yes, sir.
Click OK.
All caps or just?
Is it a hidden file?
Yes, yes. Again, percent symbol.
Yes, sir.
Now click OK.
Okay.
Yeah, like now go back, click on the app data, it is roaming folder. Go back.
Yeah, MikTek, I can see MikTek here.
Go inside and
no, check your exact location. There are three locations in the app data, local, and
yes, sir, local.
So go to the local.
Okay.
Then programs.
Yeah, there is a MikTek folder. Okay, in programs. Okay, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, go to MikTek. Yeah, and you can delete all of this.
Control A
and delete.
Don't delete the MikTek folder.
That's fine. Okay. Initially, it was on that, right? I guess it will take some time.
Yes, ma'am.
And maybe after this, you can proceed ahead with the installation.
Okay. I think it will take some time, so you can go to next question.
Yes, please. Thank you. Vivek has written that, hello, there are some minor errors in the code provided in final evaluation, both in part 1 and part 2. All right. What errors can you point out?
Hello.
Go to the course. Yes, please.
Yeah, one is on part one, probably line number 5, there is some error in the command.
All right.
And in part two. Hello.
Yes, please.
Yeah, in part two, we are not able to get the individual now if we run the same data in the same console, we will get single images in a single slide, whereas what you have done is in a slide there are two pics of the dogs.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we are not able to get that.
Okay, let's go to part one. So part one, you have said that there is an error somewhere around line number 5.
50, 50, 50.
50, all right.
Yeah.
If box. Sorry, but I'm not able to see the error. I guess it looks fine to me. Just
is it okay? Yeah.
Yeah, it looks fine to me. I don't think there is an error.
Is it okay? Fine. Because when I run the same command, I couldn't get the correct answer. But without, as there is some error, as I pointed, because I don't want to tell what is that.
Okay.
It's like I'm just showing the answer it would be. So I'm not going to tell that.
Okay. Do you get an error?
Yes. I'm not able to, if I run the same console, I'm not able to get the picture of the chloroplast of this thing.
Oh, that means the chloroplast image may not be there on your system.
No, it's there.
Okay.
If I make the changes in the command, so then this would appear, the picture would appear.
Okay. Okay, let me go through it again. It seems fine to me.
okay fine then. I think anybody else also, if they can try, they would ultimately, objective is to, they should be able to get the good output.
Okay, what I'll do is I'll try it out again, and so I have that file, let me see, because so basically I would like just admit that the entire so first the actual correct LaTeX file was created, and then these kind of options were then added to it. Okay. So let me try it out and I'll check it up again. So
part one.
Yeah, just one second. So part one, line number 50, and in part two, just a second. Yeah,
I've already submitted the answer. Everything is correct. So if I run the same on the command with the same commands, with regard to the pictures, in the slide, I believe there are two dog pictures which are appearing in two different slides.
Right.
Yeah. Now, if I run the same command on my this thing, individual pic is coming in individual slide.
Okay. I'll see that as well. Maybe there's an issue with the size of the image.
It may not be, because I have used the same command and my answers are right. A green tick mark has appeared in front of each command.
Okay.
And I've used the same thing on the console, same commands.
Okay, so let me check that as well. I'll get back on the discussion forum.
Fine, madam. Thank you.
Yes, thank you. So I just want to mention over here is that we have exceeded our time slot. I guess I'll end my session here, and I will hand over to Rama madam. Thank you very much, and please feel free to post on the discussion forum for any queries. Thank you. Yes, you can stop sharing your screen.
Ma'am, should I install it now?
Yes, you can install it. But what is, ask me first. Install missing packages on the fly. Yeah, click yes.
Okay.
After that, click yes. No, go back and say click yes. It says ask me. Just click yes, yeah. And then proceed ahead with the installation. Okay, Neelashree said that Beamer is working fine. Yes, glad to hear, Neelashree. Thank you very much. I'm handing over the session to Rama madam. Sorry for the delay. Thank you.
Hello.
Yes.
Yeah, this is Mahendra here.
Yeah, Mahendra, go ahead. So I think the next session is handled by Ritika, if I'm not mistaken. It's.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah. So, Ritika.
Hi. So Mahendra sir wanted to say a few words after that.
Okay. So Mahendra, quickly, you can say whatever you want to say, and then Ritika.
Yeah, hello everyone. My name is Mahendra Parnas, and I'm here to talk about the bulk registration, which we are taking it from the institutions. So if you're a faculty or a student of any college, then I would urge you to kindly talk to your authorities, and you can talk about the bulk registrations. There are different courses which IIT Bombay is offering. As you all already are aware about those skill development courses. Apart from this, we are also conducting CS courses and engineering core courses like engineering thermodynamics and signals and systems. So my request to all of you is to make sure that you speak to your faculty or somebody in the organization and tell them about the bulk registration facility. In the bulk registration, the fees are at discounted rate, and we appreciate that this type of registrations come forward, because we are already getting so many requests. So we just thought of like informing this to you all also, so that you can get the benefit out from this. Thank you so much.
I'm handing over the control to Ms. Vishika.
Hi everyone. I'll be answering questions for soft skills and workplace communication. So firstly, I noticed that for the workplace communication course, the discussion forum isn't very active. So I'd urge all of you to participate. You can ask your doubts there. You can share any observations. Okay, I'll start by answering questions that you've asked on the Google form. Okay, so soft skills, someone has asked, what are the skills required if I become a director of any university or get a higher post in any organization? So, if you become a director or get a higher post, that obviously entails good leadership skills, which we haven't really covered in this course because this course deals with the transition from college to corporate. But I'd just like to say that leadership skills means good listening skills, which is a unit in the course. And you should be receptive. It doesn't just mean being bossy or being assertive. That's a misconception. You should be open to ideas. You should... Sorry, am I audible? Okay. Yeah, you should be open to ideas. You should be receptive. You should... Also, you should also have good decision-making skills and you should be sure of yourself. So that comes with a lot of practice and training. Then, someone has asked, will the course content be accessible even after the course ends? Yes, it will. How to cover the course if we join it late? This is a self-paced course, so there's no weekly deadline. So you can, you're not losing out on anything. You can watch all the videos and before November 15th, you can do all the graded quizzes and then you can get the certificate.
Ma'am,
tell me.
Ma'am, here Simran. Hello.
Yes, hi Simran.
Hi ma'am, good afternoon.
Good
afternoon. Ma'am, I wanted to ask one question, that will there be any exam for this course?
Oh no, no exam. Just the graded quizzes that are there.
All right, thank you so much, ma'am.
So the next question that we have is, students find it very hard to follow online sessions even when trained with a platform. Please let me know what practice could be incorporated to make them follow. This question has been asked by Prem. Could you please clarify what exactly you mean or which online platform are you referring to? Are you referring to this course in particular or online courses in general? Prem, if you're there, we'll move on to the next question. Okay, someone has asked, is emotional intelligence good? So yes, emotional intelligence is a skill that you need to master. It basically refers to being aware of yourself, aware of your emotions. It doesn't mean not feeling, say, anger or if you're upset about something. It doesn't mean not feeling those emotions. It just means being able to identify that, okay, I'm feeling this right now and keeping them in check. And yes, it's a very important skill that you need in every realm of life, even in your personal life, in your workplace, everywhere. So the soft skill course, in fact, does deal with that. I think that's all Yeah, these are all the questions that we received on the form. Now I can take any live questions if anyone has any. For soft skills and workplace communication, does anyone have any questions?
Ma'am?
Yes, Sandhya.
Ma'am, I was going through one video yesterday because I joined late, so I am right now on forms of communication. Okay. So what ma'am was talking about, she was talking about that there should be a room for feedbacks.
Yes.
So ma'am, I really want to learn. I just joined soft skills, just want to learn that how to react on the negative feedbacks.
Yes, that's a very good question. That's something I think most of us face difficulty with when it comes to dealing with negative criticism. I think firstly you try to filter out the negative part of it and just see what you can take out of it, the constructive part, how you can improve yourself. And also see where the other person is coming from. You know, if it's an emotional feedback, if someone has just said something out of anger, then don't take it very seriously. But if someone is saying it for your own well-being, if there's some good point that you can take out of it, just try to keep your filters on.
Yes, ma'am, because I have been through some situations where people demean you or say the feedbacks in such a way where they are actually criticizing you. So that's the point where, you know, I really want to learn how to react at that particular point.
Right. So are these people, just see where they are coming from. Is their intention to demean you? In that case, you should ignore
all right.
feedback. But if you know that they mean well, if you could use it in future, then I think you should pay attention to it.
All right. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you. Anyone else? You can also ask your questions on the chat.
Hello. Yes? Madam, can you hear me?
Yes. Hi.
Madam, this is Professor Ainali speaking from Karnataka University, Karnataka.
Hi.
Regarding workplace communication, you know, sometimes what happens is my colleagues, even if they have not worked well, even if, we know very well that they are the people who always avoid working sincerely, when it comes to the meeting, at meeting, they speak first and project as if they have worked so hard and all that. And we are made not get any chance at all to speak out in the meetings. Then we are in a way silenced. We are not given any opportunity to speak out, and we are we are made to show up as if inefficient fellows. How do you manage this kind of situation?
Yeah, this is a very common problem, I guess. I think you could work on yourself more, on your speaking skills maybe. Because I guess I'm guessing that your self-confidence might be low, that's why you don't tend to speak up in meetings. What stops you from?
Kritika, can I add something to this part?
Sure.
Yeah. So what I can, from what he says, what I can read is the fact that there is a whole lot of insecurity. People typically who shirk their work. And beyond a point, right, they have to prove that they are right, and they need to be seen in the circle. Now that is when they typically rush in. All right, if you have been sincerely working, if you have been sincerely putting your effort, you need not really feel insecure at all. People who see all the bosses, all right, will know who works and who does not work, and that is basically where from where this insecurity stems up, you know. So don't worry about somebody trying to silence you. As long as you know that you're good in your work, I don't see any reason.
Let your work speak for you.
Exactly. You know. So I think that should not really bother anyone as such. I hope that satisfies your question.
Yeah, ma'am. Sure.
Anyone else?
Hello, ma'am.
Hi.
Hello, I'm Vinayak Dhule from Nandurbar. Ma'am, are you hearing me?
Yeah, we can hear you.
Okay. Ma'am, my question is that sometimes the soft skill or the workplace problems bonded with the language. Meeting is going on and something, we have to pretend something in the meeting. Then what happened? We are tried to speak in our native language first. So is it okay to follow with this when such situation is happen? Native languages while using the, while working on the workplace or in the soft skill manner when we are talking in the meetings, sometimes the native language we have to use. Is it okay or not? It will create impressions badly or correctly.
It might make other people feel left out. It's better to use a common language that everyone is comfortable with.
See, a sentence here and there is okay, Vinayak. Yeah. Okay. So, supposing to say you add a sudden, say a proverb, all right, that will kind of, give the meaning. In depth, all right, or whatever you want to say, that will be highlighted. But trying to carry a complete presentation in your language, in your native language, may probably beat the purpose. Okay, so the best thing is to once in a while you can always. So even we tend to bring in, native words here and there. Henna, okay, fine, okay. When we are talking, they keep switching, okay? So in that case, it is understood, okay? These are just expressions, okay? So to kind of take in the audience, all right? And probably make sure that they are with you, all right? Once in a while, these gestures are fine. But the presentation should be done in which the rest of the audience is comfortable. You should know who your audience is.
Okay, ma'am. Yes, I'm got your point.
Okay.
Okay, ma'am. I got your point. Thank you.
Yeah. Any other questions? I think we can wrap up soft skills and workplace for now and move to English. Rama, would you like to start?
Yeah. So do we have any more questions on soft skill? Otherwise, we can move on.
Hello, this is Kalpana here. So I request all whoever anything if you have to post it on the discussion forum, because as Ritika said, the discussion forum is not very active. So in case you have any questions, I suggest that you make full use of discussion forum, because if you ask in discussion forum, many people will benefit. So that is one thing which I think we should cultivate that habit. Of asking questions through discussion forum, and we will anyway have live sessions once a month. So you are welcome to come for the live session, but on a regular basis, you should ask your questions in the discussion forum. So that is my comment, which I thought I'll share. Thank you.
Yeah. Thanks, Kalpana.
Ma'am, may I add something?
Yeah. Go ahead, Shari.
So as ma'am rightly stated, discussion forum is very important and asking questions is basically what will get your doubts cleared. But more importantly, also, you should read through the different questions and comments already in the discussion forum, because that will help you maybe clear your doubts and probably realize doubts that you never even had, but are really pertinent or are really important.
Okay, so should we get down now to oral and written communication doubts? Welcome all the students who are right now present in this meeting. It's a lovely rainy day here, and it's a very nice feeling to have all of you discussing and asking your questions. I can see Shariq's smile. Probably it's not raining where he is. So to begin with, there was a question a student had placed on the Google form that we had asked to fill in, which said, how do we develop our word power? Okay. Now, I remember we have already done it in the, we have mentioned about this in the video, okay. The best thing that one should do is every time you have any doubt, please refer to a thesaurus. The thesaurus gives you ample amount of options as far as words are concerned. The only thing is that you have to understand the context. You have to understand the context in which you're going to use the word. And the thesaurus also does that for you. So it gives you an option as to if you mean in this particular context, what is the word that can be used basically. This is one way of developing your vocabulary. Rather than going back to a dictionary, I would rather say once you have understood the dictionary meaning, you can go to the thesaurus and enrich yourself, your vocabulary. Another way is where you try to find out words that are close to a particular supposing to say you come across a word like learning. Now, learning, there are so many words which are related to it. And you'll realize that teaching, education, erudite, recondite, scholarly. So these are the words as you, of course, get down to it, you know, you can start making groups and you will realize that this is how you can club these words together. Okay, so you write one word in between, say, for example, study. And on the basis of that, you start making, circle that word and start making an arrow in whichever direction and keep writing whatever words that, so study will also mean learning. It also means education. It also means teaching. Teaching, studying becomes a process. So whatever words that you find are close by, all right, and then keeping in mind whatever situation that you are in, you are placed in, you will realize that you can make use of these words very comfortably. Okay, so I hope that answers your query as to how should one develop. Other than that, of course, there are other ways when it comes to listening skills, you know, because you are grasping several words at a time. So there are if you listen to TED Talks, if you listen to other good documentaries, if you happen to watch on YouTube, say, for example, these will give you a whole lot of exposure to good listening as well as speaking skills. You know, both these skills can be managed. You know? So these are a few ways in which one can enrich your language, enrich your vocabulary. I hope that answers the question. Can I ask Shariq to take the next question regarding the placing of period and noun?
Sure. Actually, I don't have access to the list of questions.
Okay, we'll just send it to you on your WhatsApp. She'll just...
Yeah, sure. So,
yeah.
I sent you the picture on WhatsApp.
You mean the one about the comma?
Yes, that's right, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I got confused for a second there. So yeah, this was a question that was also asked in the forum, discussion forum. So if any of you had read through that, perhaps this question could have been answered then. And what I've done right now is I've pinned this question so that if any of you are not following the explanation that I give right now, you can always go back and read the detailed explanation that I've written along with examples. So basically, there is something called an Oxford comma. And that is something I will explain in a bit. Now, the question that arose was, one second, I will just read out the question in its entirety. English for written communication, my question is as follows. When there are more than two nouns in series, they are separated by a comma. And before the last word, we use and. The question is, in many places of your presentation, you have used comma followed by and. And in some places, no comma followed by and. So which format should be used for written technical documents? Now, as we've all probably learned in school, you use commas to separate lists. Whenever you're listing things down, you use a comma and you end with an and you place the last item. And that's a general rule of thumb that we've learned. But sometimes what happens is if we follow this rule blindly, we create ambiguous situations. And by ambiguous, I mean confusing situations when something is not clear. For example, let's take this sentence that I had written in the discussion forum. It's a little funny, but bear with me. I would like to thank my parents. For my success, I would like to thank my parents, comma, Rama and Ritika. Now, what happens here, it becomes very confusing. Are your parents Rama and Ritika? Or do you want to thank your parents, Rama and Ritika? So what needs to be done here, a comma needs to be inserted before and. Because now what happens is, I would like to thank my parents, comma, Rama, sorry, am I missing out the order? Comma and Ritika. So this is what clearly demarcates who all you're trying to thank. And this is called the Oxford comma. Whenever a conjunction is there and you need to place a comma before the conjunction, that comma is called the Oxford comma. So now the question arises is, can you keep using it all the time? Ideally, you shouldn't, because we tend to use one rule and we keep sticking with it. You want to do this and you keep doing this. But try and make sure that you use it appropriately. Whenever the situation demands it, whenever there is confusion in the sentence, use the comma. Now, when it comes to technical writing, I will try and share a link with you that I looked up before I was trying to answer this question. I'll just put it in the chat. So this is from a university called Cornell and for their engineering students. And basically, they explain it really well. Even when you're writing reports, scientific reports or engineering reports, and there are technical sentences where you're trying to explain the different chemicals someone should use, what happens is if you leave the Oxford comma out, if you just blindly follow the rule, I have to put those commas in place wherever and then just put an and the last bit. So let's say for this experiment, we need to use hydrogen peroxide, sulfur dioxide, hydrogen peroxide, comma, sulfur dioxide, comma, sodium and water. Now, what happens here is sodium and water becomes one group. And somebody might think sodium needs to be mixed into the water. Or rubidium, rubidium needs to be mixed into the water. Now, what can happen is for science students who are here would realize that this is a highly exothermic reaction. That means it's going to bubble and it might even explode because it's very violent, the reaction. And you don't want that to happen. So someone who's following someone, let's say in a different country, is reading your report and is trying to emulate or replicate the same experiment, he or she might not follow it properly and it'll end in a disaster. And so this is something, it's very important. A lot of people don't realize, but for technical reports specifically, you need to make sure your Oxford commas are in the right place. And this is not limited to engineering or scientific fields, even for business. So I don't have a particular example. I will get back to you with it. but I hope you follow the gist of it. And if you don't, go to the discussion forum. I've posted the Oxford style guide, which you can read on page 13, what the Oxford comma is and how the sentences look like. Try and go through that. And if you have any more questions, keep posting it on the discussion forum. I hope that answers the question.
Yeah, thanks, Shari. That was quite in detail and extremely satisfying in the sense that to also make it a little simpler, one can always say the sun, the moon, and the stars. You don't say sun, moon, stars, right? So this is basically our V8, laddus, comma, jalebis, and whatever, you know, gulab jamuns as well. So what he's asking and the way you have, so, and of course this all gets replicated with your technical writing as well, you know, so that was an excellent answer, you know, just the right way to explain. Thanks. Yeah, so do we have any more questions?
Guys, now is the time. I mean, get all your questions clarified. And if you have any inhibitions, this is a completely non-judgmental zone. No one's going to come and tell you, oh, he doesn't know this or she doesn't know this. This is how we learn. So please don't hesitate. Like, go ahead and ask your questions.
Okay, so what I noticed as far as in the meanwhile, people can put up their questions if they have any. What I have noticed is in the Google form, there are students who have been, yes.
Can you hear me, ma'am?
Yeah.
Hello?
Yes, go ahead.
Madam, when I watched the videos related to oral communication, what I felt was, most of the students are coming from rural areas, who have studied in native languages, in mother tongues.
Okay.
Among them, I find, much difficulty in, cultivating some sentence linkers, gap fillers, and these kind of things. So I thought it would be better if there was one video which could inform the students about how to use gap fillers and sentence linkers, these kind of things. If the students are good at grammar and if they are able to, make the sentences properly with grammatical knowledge, they could speak English as you have, taught in the videos. It would be easy for them, definitely.
I understand what you're saying.
But the rural students are not good at making use of these kind of sentence fillers. And, they give a kind of, liveliness when we are using the language.
I understand. So see, what we have done is grammar we have spread out in both the modules, in the oral as well as the written module, except for determiners. We have covered almost everything that is a part of grammar as per se, in the sense we have picked up articles, tenses, prepositions. So all of these things, they link words. So words in the sense noun, verb, adjective, adverb, they link these things together to make a complete sentence. Now you will have to be very patient, go through both the modules. Only then will you realize that including the subject verb connection, understanding those things, or punctuations, for example, everything has been in fact covered except for the A and the determiners, where and how they are to be used, of course, which otherwise get covered in articles as such. Okay, so I think we have more or less covered what is basic required for this course. Does that answer your question?
Hello?
Yeah, does that answer your question?
No, madam, that is what I want to make clear.
I think you did not get my point clearly. My point was that, you know, there will be certain linkers, you know, like actually, you know, to put it in other words, you know, these kind of, you know, certain catchwords and phrases will be there, which are often used in the sentence. The students who have come from English medium.
Well, honestly speaking, we do not encourage these fillers. One should not use it. Basically, the point is these fillers gives the speaker time to think and recollect the word. But the person should be so prepared with his content that he should not, a good speaker should not be using these fillers.
Now, how did it possible in oral communication, madam?
Yeah, yeah. In oral communication only, I'm saying. You should, this, whatever we do, we take these pauses, as I call it, not fillers, but I call it pauses.
To gain some time, yes.
Exactly. Yes. So for these pauses, you have punctuations basically used in a sentence. All right. Mm. I paused just now and I took my time to gather my thoughts, my words. That is okay. But rather than saying, you know, okay, fine. Rather than doing that, it is always nice to just wait for a couple of seconds, gather your thoughts and go on. Ritika has something to say. Yeah.
Just adding to your point, you know, actually and all are actually called crutch words because people use it when they can't find any other words and they use it like crutches to support them. So yeah,
that is what is required for the students to understand.
No, actually, it's not required. You should tell them
they are not supposed to use it.
In day-to-day communication, madam, when it is happening naturally. Informal situations are different from formal situations, you know.
That is true. But then as far as possible, one should also not make use of it in informal situations. We would rather discourage, because see, that becomes your habit. And once it becomes a habit, all right, when it comes to, now see, I used all right. Okay. So once, then it becomes a habit. And when it comes to presentations, students will be doing presentations all the time, right? In that case, then it becomes a part of their presentation in that case then. So they're not supposed to, all right, actually, okay, fine.
But, and it doesn't mean you have good grammar if you use those words.
Yes.
As long as your sentences are correctly formed at home.
Yeah, so does that answer your question, sir?
Yes, ma'am, yes.
Okay, thank you so much. Yeah.
Hello, ma'am, Vinayak here. Vinayak here, ma'am, again.
Yeah, hi, Vinayak.
Yeah, Vinayak, can you just hold on 1 minute? I think there is Ms. Kanjan Pandya who has been trying to ask a question. I have already spoken to you, Vinayak. Will you just hold on 1 second? Yes, Kanjan,
yes,
if you are... Yeah. Thank you so much, Vinayak. Yeah, Kanjan, if you are there,
Hello, ma'am. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Ma'am, I joined the course before few days only, matlab before 4 to 5 days only. So is it okay for me to complete the whole the syllabus up to November?
Oh, yes. As Ritika has said, it is a self-paced course and you can take your own time, but make sure that you finish it on the given date so that the certification and everything can be done. Complete all the question answers, the quizzes, whatever is given there, all of those things so that you qualify for, the procedure kind of, whatever the requirements are.
Originally, one more thing I want to tell you. I'm sorry, ma'am.
I'm saying originally it was planned out to be a 4-week course. So you have enough time.
Okay. I want to say something.
Hello.
Before 4 years, I was gone through the hemorrhage and that affect my fine motors. So my writing is not as the others are having. Right now, my writing has become very late in coming. Okay. So that is the problem in my writing that I want to say you that if you are seeing my writing, then don't tell anything about it.
Oh, don't worry. Don't worry. Okay. Now that you've mentioned, we'll be considered rather. Okay.
Okay. Okay.
If I might add something, Kanjan, now that you mentioned this, in case you're facing difficulties with writing because of your condition, you can always, what you can do is you can dictate to somebody and they can help you write down the stuff. That way, it might not. 1 second, Channabaswa, I will just answer Kanjan's question and then we will get back to you. We also have Vinayak to speak to. So, Kanjan, what I'm trying to say is, as long as you can get your idea across and make sure that your grammar and your sentence structure is unfiltered and unedited by whoever's writing it down for you, then it is okay for someone else to write for you and upload the document, if that makes life easier for you. At the end of the day, we don't want to burden you.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir. Thank you so much. Actually, I'm good at board writing because I'm a teacher right now. So I'm good at board writing because that skill I have developed. But in a particular, in a writing in notes, I'm somehow, my writing is still really very bad. So I'm just going to develop it, it too. But this may be taking some time.
Take your time.
Okay. Doesn't matter. Take your time. It's absolutely fine.
Okay. Okay, ma'am.
Yeah. Vinayak, can you, are you there? Hello?
Hi. Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Ma'am, my question is that whenever we are following through the report writings, etc., and we are trying to check the plagiarism online, all the things, sometimes the indefinite and definite articles are able to present there, or they are required there, but the sentence says that it is grammatically correct. Sometimes we are using the India, or we are using only India, still the correct. And in the video, we have mentioned that, sometimes the keeping the articles is good, no problem at all. So what we actually follow while writing the report, articles are not able to place at the right place by me sometimes. So how you guys?
Okay. See, this confusion regarding articles is always there simply because, well, you'll be surprised, none of the Indian languages uses articles. It is only the English language that has articles in it. Okay. Now, probably that is one of the reasons as to why Indians get confused, you know, when it comes to writing articles. But you seem to be understanding the definite and indefinite articles and things like that. If you go through the video again and again, okay, I think your understanding will improve. And it's basically more of listening to others speak and reading stuff that will give you confidence as to where the article goes and where it doesn't, you know. Write more, get it corrected, and you will realize that articles are an integral part of English language. You cannot do away the articles, okay? So it's not that, you know, you can just drop them. They have to be used. And it can never be the India, okay? So just make sure that you understand the content.
No, ma'am, actually, I'm just saying you, on internet, I put the word D India in the example, and I say spell check, or I says the what is the correction in the sentence. Still, the correction is no correction in the line is there. It is already corrected by the online checker, whatever the websites are available. It's it is a correct D India. And after the removing the India, the word article, it is again saying that, yes, it is also correct. So I'm getting confused whether I'm wrong or the internet is wrong.
I think the websites are maybe not checking anything, or just fooling people to, you know, you're entering something. So you may have to look at good resources like Grammarly or something like that.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
That's a really good point. Yes. Sorry, Vinayak, I don't mean to cut you off. Go ahead.
No, sir.
I was just going to add that what happens sometimes with using these softwares is that not all of these softwares are properly calibrated. And these softwares, sometimes they're soft, like the coding behind it, it does not account for everything. Especially, I'm guessing, do you use Google Translate? Because Google Translate has a lot of problems, especially when translating from Indian languages to English. So you want to be very careful whenever you use softwares like this. What happens is, if you want to use Google Translate to communicate on a very basic level with somebody, let's say you are in a different state. Like if I was from Maharashtra and I spoke Marathi, I went to Bengal and I was trying to speak to Bengali and he doesn't know English, I don't know English, we have Google Translate. So that is when you use Google Translate a little bit so that you can get your point across. But if you want to write stuff professionally, I highly recommend that you do not use Google Translate except for understanding the meaning of individual words. Don't try and formulate sentences on Google Translate because it does not work out well.
Okay, sir. Thank you. And sir, last question, then I have no question at all. The question is to you only, sir. So I'm a little bit confused about the grading policy. At the last, it is covering 80% weightage to the graded quizzes and 20% to the practice quizzes. So if I'm getting total at the last column, when there's at the progress bar, we are getting the 50%, then we are able to get the certificate, or individually we have to complete 50-50%?
I'll try and answer that for you. Basically, the practice quizzes do not contribute to your final grade. It is the actual quizzes that contribute to your final grade, and the graded assignment at the end, the one with the essay and the letter that you have to write about the analyst position at ABC, if you've read the assignment. So I believe the split is 60% for the quizzes and 40% for the assignment. And correct me if I'm wrong, Rama and Ritika, but I believe that if you get 50% overall is when you get the certificate. It doesn't have to be 60, 50. It doesn't have to be. You have to pass all your quizzes and pass the assignment, and that is only when you will get the certificate. If you don't do well in some quizzes, but you do well in your assignment and do well in your other quizzes, you can still get the certificate. I hope that answers your question.
Yes, sir. Means you are talking about the last column in the progress bar, last column, which is a composite of the graded and the all quizzes. Progress bar in our individual modules.
Progress bar. Let me have a look at this progress bar. I am on the website right now. Yeah, it says GQ, GQ average, PQ, practice quiz average, and then total.
At the last column, sir, it will cover the all the mixture of the 80% of this and 20% of what we say, practice quiz and graded quizzes.
So the breakup is 60-40, not 80-20.
Yes, ma'am, 60-40, I'm sorry. But at the last, we have the average of all.
Right.
I see what you mean. I see the confusion, because when you press the progress bar, it says graded quiz, and then it says practice quiz, and then it says total. And then it says past 50% and 100%. But what I'm trying to say is the practice quiz does not contribute towards your final grade. It might look that way on the graph, but the practice quiz is purely for practice. We don't count it for your final grade. So when you refer to that graph, don't get confused.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yeah, do well on your assignment. That's very important. The final assignment at the end, not the progress bar. If you go to graded assignment in under the modules, then check that assignment. That is 40%. And all the other graded quizzes are 60%. If you want, I can send a link to the graded assignment on this chat.
Okay, sir. Please send. Thank you, sir.
Yeah, I'll do that for you. Someone else had a question. I forgot. After Vinayak wanted to speak. Who else was it?
It's me. That was...
Yes.
It's me, sir.
Go for it.
Can I?
Yeah.
So my question is, this course is modeled on MOOC, I think.
So MOOC course is considered even for promotion things related to assistant professors and all that. Could this course also be considered like that? While applying for promotions of assistant professors, we have certain courses like faculty development programs and short-term courses like this. MOOC course are equivalent to those courses. MOOC course could substitute them. So could this also be considered for that kind of thing?
Okay. So what happens is this is a MOOC course. And if your...
Hello?
Can you hear me? Hello?
Yes, sir. I can hear.
Yeah. So what I'm trying to say is the course that we have designed, this is a MOOC course. And if wherever you're applying for a position, if the requirement there states that you can use a MOOC course to substitute for a short-term course or for any other course, then yes, for all purposes and intents, this is a MOOC course, and then they should accept it. I'm not saying they will.
Yes.
You need to check with them. So that is the best idea. Go ahead and speak to them whether this course is okay for you to apply for your assistant professor position. But this is a MOOC course, that much I can assure you.
Yes, sir.
We are also giving out certificates.
Why I inquired is that, sir. Sir, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you. Hello?
Sorry, am I audible, sir?
Yeah.
You are. Hmm. 1 month's MOOC course is considered to be equivalent for 1 week's short-term course, sir. So I think on the same basis, I could make use of this course also for my promotion things and all that. So I just wanted to get it confirmed.
That is wonderful.
Definitely be an advantage.
Yeah. Yeah. And also in our course, we cover how to I believe either Ritika or Rama have an entire video dedicated to cover letters, CVs, yeah. Resumes. So you can use that also in your professional endeavor. You can make sure that you mention everything properly and you write how this course and the skill sets that you acquired in this course will help you fulfill the role or the position you're applying for. So this course helps you not only to meet your requirements, but also very practically to market yourself and sell yourself for that position to wherever you're applying to.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Yep.
Make sure that you get your certificate at the end of the course. You can always attach that certificate also along with your resume.
Sure, ma'am.
Okay. Yeah. Do we have any more questions?
Okay, there's a question on the form that we have.
Hello.
Yes. Hello? Can we have your question, okay. Satishan?
Here is Satishan.
Actually,
I have completed only 2 modules of this course so far, as
okay.
I have got registration very recently.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
And I wonder that there would be some. There will be a particular module for connected speech along with this, all these things, because the stress patterns and all those things are very useful since it is concerned with oral communication. So could I know, ma'am, if there is a certain module about or pertaining to connected speech?
Well, we are doing the basic communications, oral communication course. So
yeah.
I don't think we have incorporated anything to do with what you have inquired. Yeah, but we of course focus on sounds and
yeah.
Their use. So
yeah.
you could actually go through the complete oral course, and I'm sure you would definitely because there is a whole 2 or 3 videos dedicated only to pronunciations and sounds and their articulation.
Here is what I got the doubt, that is because I did not complete so far, and I'm waiting for completing the rest of the modules in this program. Therefore, I was just saying that I wanted to make sure that yes, whether this is also included or incorporated.
It is definitely. Sounds is definitely included in the course, and you have ample time to finish the course, because the end date of both the courses is somewhere around November 20th or 25th, if I'm not mistaken. So you still have enough. You have around 2 months to go, and I just hope your questions are answered and you enjoy the course.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you so much. Yes. Do we have any other questions? Ritika, you want to take some question?
Rama, can I very quickly clarify something with you? So I remember Vinayak was just asking us the question about what the split was, and I explained to him it was 60-40 with 60 to the graded quizzes and 40 to the assignment. But I was just checking the oral communication course, the other one, not the written one. And in that course, the progress bar shows that graded quizzes and practice quizzes both have weightage. So that is what he might be referring to. And I don't want him to get confused and like not focus on his practice quizzes now.
I think he'll find it out, I guess. Yeah.
Hopefully.
Hello. Excuse me.
Yes. Tell us, Satish.
I have just before in the chat box, I have seen that somebody has posted about the written communication. Probably I might not have read the whole the instructions given earlier. So here is my doubt, that is it possible for us to go for the written communication hand in hand, means along with this oral communication?
Definitely.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
So what we have done is we have basically split, communication skills into 4 modules, 4 parts.
Okay.
So listening, speaking, reading, and writing. If you have to understand a particular language, all of these aspects have to be taken into consideration. And this course has been basically designed around these 4 skills. So just focusing on oral skills will not be enough, because when it comes to expressing your thought and ideas, written skills are also quite important. And in that case, you should enroll for written skills as well for a proper completion of the course as such. So I would strongly recommend that you enroll for written communication as well.
Certainly. I'll do it. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Yes.
Welcome.
Okay, there was one question in the form that we left out. It says, I'm still facing difficulty in framing sentences and questions. I'm listening and speaking English. Please guide me and correct my mistakes. So, when you say difficulty in framing sentences, and you've said you're listening and speaking, you've not mentioned writing. I think writing is what you need to do, because when you write stuff, you see the way you framed your sentences better. When you speak, you don't pay that much attention to what you're saying. But when it's written, you can see exactly where you missed a punctuation or missed a word or whatever. So have you enrolled for the written communication course? In which case, the first unit deals with this, the unit on syntax, deals with how you should frame your sentences.
My advice on this would be, please do not get frustrated with the fact that you have still not got the hang of it. See, the module itself, the lectures, the videos, if you see, are pretty short. They're only 10 minutes, maximum 15 minutes, okay? Now, this is not enough to basically get a hang of either any language or learning as a matter of fact. Give yourself ample time, even beyond the course, all right? I think you should keep continuing. At some point, I'm sure you would realize that, without noticing, you would realize that you have already started getting a hang of it. As I always say, it is almost like losing weight. You know, gaining is easy, but losing, one tends to get a bit frustrated and we tend to give it up, you know. So the only advice here would be not to give up, keep trying, and it will anyway come, you know. So just have that little bit of patience. Don't get frustrated. Keep thinking, keep listening, keep thinking, keep listening, and yeah, reading also as well, you know. So yeah, Ritika wants to say something.
Just feel free to upload your writing on the discussion forum. We'll give you feedback, anything, if it's a letter or essay, whatever.
Guys, the most powerful thing about this course is the fact that you can upload anything you write and you can get a corrected feedback. Yeah. This is generally, we were just entertaining a doubt with, I'm not sure if it was Vinayak or who it was, but about how he uses Google Translate or he uses other softwares to try and correct the things, and he gets the wrong answer and he tries to use it with the definite in the indefinite article he mentioned. And now you have actual teachers and people willing and ready and able to correct your answers. So make the most of this opportunity and write your doubts, write your thoughts, use the discussion forum. That's the most important thing.
Okay, do we have any more questions? Because we are almost coming to the close of this session. Another 5 minutes if there are any doubts, questions, or else we can wrap it up.
So like Mukesh wrote in the chat, he asked a question and Ritika answered it. Other people, if you're shy about speaking out, you can always type in the chat. That's also completely okay. We'll answer your question. So this is your moment. This is your time. You have 5 minutes more. So try and make the most of it.
So just a quick announcement before we wind up. So there is bulk registration options available for colleges. So in case your college would be interested, please contact us. So the contact information is given here. Or you can contact Mahendra and you can send a mail to eoutreach@csc.iitb.ac.in. So, and the phone number is also given. So, please tell your teachers and college authorities in case you would be interested in bulk registration. Thank you.
Ma'am, is there an additional slide with the contact information? Because this slide...
Mahendra, if you have the contact information, just...
So I have just posted on the chat. What I'll do is I'll just edit the PPT file and share it over here straight away. Give me 1 minute time.
If there are more questions, please feel free to ask. Rama, Ritika, and Sharik, if you want to say something, you can just maybe.
Okay, I'll just add something real quickly. So like I've said, like I'm probably going to repeat myself again, but there is a 40% graded assignment on the written course. So in order to do well, on it, I would highly recommend you use the practice writing courses and make sure that you send your writings across either on the discussion forum or as a on the discussion forum so that we can correct it and you can get an idea of what we expect for the written assignment. So remember, written assignment is a very big part. If you ace your written assignment, as in you do well on it, then 40% of your grade is already cleared. You only need 10% from the quizzes and you get your certificate, which is not to say don't perform well on your quizzes, but your written assignment is a very big part, so please focus well on it.
Also, please use the discussion forum as much as you can. Share whatever you read. If you want to write something and share it with us, because we are always reading. So please do. Please use it.
Yeah, and my suggestion will be to keep going back to the videos just in case you have not understood anything. The concepts will definitely be clear. Just to make sure that rather than just feeling being stuck at some point, just make sure that you rerun the videos, because it's a free tool in your hand. So you can obviously press the rewind button and go back, see the videos again. That will help you definitely.
And even the practice essay and letter writing questions, I know they aren't graded, but please try to do it and share it with us.
Good afternoon, Kondo.
Okay, so I think we have more or less come to an end of this session. Thank you all for your inputs and your questions, your doubts. We look forward to more of these questions in the coming weeks. We can definitely have one more of such question answer session. Thank you so much.
So thank you. Rama, Ritika, and Sharif, it was very nice. So this is the information about the bulk registration. So in case you want to go for bulk registration, your college, you can tell your college people. And so the contact information is also given here. So please note it down. And I want to thank all the participants for participating in the live session very enthusiastically. It was very nice of you to spare some time. And we will have such, I think many people are asking whether we will have such sessions every month. So we will announce it on the course. And we expect you to participate. And if you have any questions, can always post on the discussion forum or come live during the interactive session. And as I mentioned in the beginning, so I think many people are getting confused whether, because they joined late, whether they'll have enough time to complete the course or when will they get the certificate. These are very common questions which most of the people are asking. So I just want to tell you that this is a MOOC, which is like a initially it was designed for a 4-week or 6-week MOOC, but now we have kept it as a self-paced MOOC. That means you can finish the course at your own pace, and the whole course content is available to you, and you can do it anytime, anywhere. And we have kept the courses open until middle of November. So from July 15th till November 15th, you have 4 months time to complete any of these courses. And if you have finished English for oral communication, then I suggest that you join the English for written communication, as the instructors told you, both will go hand in hand, and so it will be better that you register for both these courses so that you become good in the language. So that is my suggestion. And similarly, if the soft skills and workplace communication, these two courses go hand in hand. So if you're registered for one, please do register for the other one so that you become better. And so with that, I would like to end this session, and I thank everybody for coming in and, you know, sparing the time, and thank you all.